Hey everybody, Richard J. Brown here, the pastor of Kingsway Community Life Center. We're in the midst of our 21-day fast, and as we fast and consecrate, I just want to give you some encouragement from the Word of God. The Bible tells us in Psalm 37 and 23 that the Lord directs the steps of the godly. He delights in every detail of their lives, and though they stumble, they will not fall, because God holds them by the hand. So often in life, we are the ones to decide who we want to be, where we want to go. Even as children, we're asked the question, so what do you want to be when you grow up? There is this unspoken pressure to decide, to know who we are, to know where we ought to be. And this unspoken pressure actually becomes spoken as we grow, because somewhere in our teenage years, there's a deadline affixed to it as we progress towards post-education or the workforce. There is something that we need to do. There is somebody that we need to become. I want to encourage you in this fast, as you seek God, that you cannot correctly know and discover your destiny or fulfill that destiny void of God. What am I saying? There is a divine design for your life. Joseph was given a dream. David had an encounter with a prophet. Joshua was given a mentor, Moses. Jeremiah tells us that God has a plan. Not only does he have a plan, but it's a good plan. Not only is it a good plan, but as we seek him, we will discover the path to that plan. There is a path, there is a route, there is a process to our promise. Job says, he knows the way that I take. God knows the way, God knows the plan. He knows exactly what he has for your life. That's why we're fasting, that's why we're seeking him, because we've come to realize that God has the best plan. And God knows the path that will take us there, because it's hard to have a dream and to hold on to a dream when you're encountering calamities and accusations like Joseph did. It's the words of the prophet can fade away when you find yourself in the caves of life like David did. And the lessons that you've learned from your apprenticeship can leave you in a lonely place when your mentor is gone, like Joshua found. But these three, they all experienced what Mary experienced as she was given her instructions and her path for life after the angel had brought salutations and the divine message from God. The angel ends the message in Luke chapter 1 by saying, "For with God, nothing shall be impossible." What is he saying? No word from God is without power. Everything that God tells you, everything that God reveals to you, everything that God has for you is backed up by his power. That word power means ability or capacity. God has the capacity to take you from where you are to where you need to be. That's why we fast. That's why we surrender to his plan, because his plan will take us through the vicissitudes, the ups and downs, the calamities, the trials and the issues of life. And his plan assures that we will end at greatness, that we will arrive in a great place. The Bible says that even though the waters have gone over our head and we've gone through the fire and we've gone through the flood, that he has brought us out into a wealthy place. God has wealth for you in the future. Your destiny and the plan for your life is that you be holistically wealthy, is that you be greater, but there is a plan, there is a path that we must follow. So I encourage you and I challenge you as you fast to surrender. Surrender to his will. Surrender to his way. Let's pray today. Father, we honor you, we bless you, we thank you, mighty God, that you are directing our steps. We thank you that you delight in every detail of our life, And that even though we stumble at times, we will not fall because you hold us. Your plan, mighty God, holds us. We thank you that you have the best plan, and we surrender to that now. I pray for every person that's under the sound of my voice that they would surrender to the divine design that you have for them. And so, God, that as they journey from where they are to where they need to be, as they encounter troubles and storms and issues, mighty God, they would not fall. Oh God, they would not be detracted or deterred from who they are and where they're supposed to be. We surrender to your will for our lives. We love you and we honor you now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you as you continue to consecrate.